What's one of the most important things that you as an umpire have to do before you go out to umpire a game? A good pregame conference. Something that you and your partner, or even in some cases, your partners, must have in order to have an effective game. Hi, I'm Jeff from Umpire Zone. I know it's been about a winter since you've seen me here on the channel, but I'm here to help you get ready for the 2019 officiating season. I've got baseball coming up in just about a month here in Connecticut, and I'm, for one, looking very excited in my 12th year of officiating here in the state, and I'm really excited to bring you some more tips and some information that you probably need to get yourself back on the right track. So anyway, let's talk about pregame. When you're getting set up for a game, it's super important that the first time you talk to your partner is not 15 minutes before the game. Sometimes your partner rolls up and maybe they'll call you and let you know that they're coming at a certain time, but sometimes you'll get to the field and if you've just introduced yourself to your partner 15 minutes before the game, you've had no time whatsoever to develop any sort of working chemistry, so you and your partner are very likely going to have something come up where maybe the two of you don't know how each of you handle the situation. A good case in point here, there's an example from either this past year or a couple years ago, there was a state final. This is a video that was shown to me at my association meeting on Tuesday night. There was a state final, two-man system, and they had one of the worst situations that could possibly pop up in any umpiring scenario, no matter what the game is. In this case, it was a tournament final. They had a double call at third base. Plate umpire was coming up third base line. The base umpire was rolling over to the third base, and they both were there for a call at third base, and one called safe, and one called out. That was chaotic. And how they resolved it was not, you know, probably one of the best situations that you could have. I'm sure if you look it up on YouTube, you can find that video. I know that the whole game is available, but there's like a snippet of like a two and a half minute video that we had on YouTube. And it was chaotic. It was something you definitely don't want to put yourself in. Definitely envy the two umpires that were in that situation. So anyway, what can you do to make sure that kind of stuff does not happen? It's having a good pregame. There's some good things that you can do, good habits that you can develop. And I want to share a few of them with you today in this video. Habit number one, call your partner a couple of days before your game. You might be thinking, huh? A couple of days? Sometimes the first time, like I said before, sometimes the first contact you have with your partner is 15 to 30 minutes before the game. 30 if you're lucky, of course, but 15 to 30 minutes before the game. That's way too little time. You need to call your partner. You need to talk to him or her, as the case may be, and talk to them about where you're going to meet. What are you going to wear? What time are we expected to be there? What are the teams that are playing? A little bit of information about the game just to get you in the mindset. Introduce yourself. Hi, I'm Jeff. Nice to meet you. I look forward to working with you. Those are all great things. I work with a lot of guys throughout the year, and like I said, in some cases, some women. And it's something that I'm trying to get better at myself, and I'm really going to make it a point this year, make it a point to introduce myself to my partners before we get to the actual game. So that's one of the things you want to do. Now, obviously, that's one of the easy things that you do pregame, but what about when you get there? So when you get there, there's going to be things that you're going to want to talk about. So here's tip number two. Talk about as much as possible, okay? A very handy thing. Your association probably has a guide, mine does, about things that you can discuss during your pregame conference. My list right here is 15 items. I've got it right here in front of me, just below the camera. 15 items, and obviously each of those is slightly itemized. No, I'm not going to read all 15 of them to you because it is kind of a long list, but there are some good things that you're going to want to talk about. Here's a short list. What time is the game starting? What are the things that you want to talk about? Maybe you want to share some game situations that you've come into in the past, some things maybe you want to do, some stories you want to tell, just to kind of lighten the mood. And then what do you want to talk about? The actual game itself. What are you going to do for rotations? What are the signals that you're going to use? What are the things that you have for fair and foul ball responsibilities? Are you going to do something different how are you going to signal to your partner, if you're the base umpire, that you're going out to the outfield to make a call so you know the plate umpire's got to roll up? What are you going to do in a lot of the situations that might come up? Some of the things you might want to consider. Signals. What are you going to use for the infield fly? What are you going to use to signal rotation? What are you going to use to indicate that you're staying home? What are you going to do in all of the situations? The more that you discuss, the better and more effective your during-game situations will be. We have a little thing called Murphy's Law. I'm sure you've heard of it, right? If you don't talk about it, of course it's going to happen. In baseball, that happens more often than not. All right, so what are the few other things that you probably want to talk about? How are you going to handle fake tags and pulled foot, maybe even fake tags or swipe tags. I was going to swipe tags. What are you going to, how are you going to handle those things? Some guys, they prefer to be a little more close to the vest about it. Maybe they'll give a hand signal or some sort of gesture to indicate that they need help. Maybe they'll want a conference with the plate umpire so you can discuss it that way. Some guys, I'm one of these guys, they just like to point right to you and say, hey, do you have a pulled foot? Or hey, do you have a swipe tag? Or whatever verbiage you want to use. Those are things that you're going to want to talk about with your partner, because maybe your partner is one, somebody who isn't as, out about that. Maybe he is one who likes to have a play discussion when you have incidents like that, such as with a pulled foot or a swipe tag. So, you want to make sure you do that. Now, the other things you're going to talk about when you're talking about pregame, okay? After you've had your good discussion, and like I said, follow that guide that your association should have available to you. Follow that guide, and then make sure that you're communicating with the coaches. What's the start time? Are we starting at 4 o'clock? Are we all set, coach? Have you got your players ready to go? Pre-game meeting, plate meeting is 3:55. If you're the plate umpire, you're the one who's running that meeting. So make sure that you're the one who's asking all the questions and saying things such as, is your team legally and properly equipped? Can we expect good sporting behavior at all times? Also, a few other things you want to do, not just before the game, but even going into the game. Learn the head coach's first names, okay? Don't just call him coach or her coach, as the case may be. Learn their first names. Address them by name. Introduce them as with your name, so they hopefully will use your first name too, because it's a sign of mutual respect. Make sure that you get that information as soon as possible. Make sure you go over with your partner how you're going to handle very unusual situations, as we said before, with the pull foot swipe tag. Yeah, it doesn't happen every game, but how are you going to handle it? If there's an argument, how are you going to handle, like, say, if coaches are coming at you, what do you want your partner to do? Do you want your partner to kind of stand back, or do you want your partner to kind of start walking towards, especially if he feels that there's going to be an ejection? You know, again, these are things that don't happen very often, but it's very good to talk about, even just for a little bit. So again, in closing, these are the kinds of things that you want to do. Make sure that your pregame is just as important as your during game, okay? Because without a good pregame, you're really setting yourself up for failure and a misunderstanding of a lot of situations. So hopefully this video helped you. Again, I hope you're looking forward to your new season. I can't wait to get into the slight rule changes, but more importantly, some of the knowledge of your rule book, because many of you are going to be taking your refresher exams, myself included, and maybe if you're a new umpire, you're going to be taking your entrance exam probably in a couple of weeks. So hopefully some of the videos I have coming down the line will help you out. Anyway, hope you had a wonderful day. This is Jeff from Umpire Zone, and if you got questions or you have things about your pregame or points you want to make about pregame, put them in the comments below. I would love to see them and love to reply and love for you to contribute as well. Have a wonderful evening. Don't forget to be awesome.